Hello all, my name is Rajani Kanth Valluru. I'm an Agile trainer and one of the organizers for Regional Scrum Gathering to be held at Hyderabad on March 29th and 30th. And today I'm your host for Meet the Speaker of Regional Scrum Gathering Hyderabad. And I have with me Ms. Satya Yellapantula. She's an accomplished Agile practitioner with over 14 years of experience. And she has worked with major IT players such as Microsoft, Deloitte, United Health, Tech Assistance. And she is an expert Zumba dancer and a Toastmaster. And she is a proud mother of two beautiful children, aged 10 and 6. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Satya Yellapantula. Over to you, Satya.
Hi, Rajani. That was a very detailed introduction. Thanks for that. And feeling really welcomed into the Regional Scrum Gathering 2019 Hyderabad. Just to add to the introduction that you have given, I also train Agile. I am an Agile and Scrum trainer at my current workplace, which is Pega Systems. I train all the new hires into the organization. At the same time, I'm also Agile and Scrum trainer for the college students in the universities where Pega has tie up with as part of Pega University program. And this is something that I really look forward to every year. The students are so enthusiastic to learn, understand what Agile is all about, what Scrum is all about. And the maximum audience that I have trained so far in one classroom has been it's 160 plus students, and that was an awesome experience.
Oh, fantastic. Okay, so how do you manage, you know, like the Zumba dancing, the training, and being a Toastmaster? How do you manage all this?
And the biggest thing to manage is the two kids.
I totally missed them.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think it's all time management. I am a true agilist. I really believe in being agile. Okay. So I plan for the day much earlier, at least a day prior. I plan what should be my menu, what time we wake up, how do I, you know, get ready to work, what is the menu for the kids in the lunchbox. So definitely plan, and there is change based on the priority. So suppose there is all of a sudden there is a meeting in the office, then I plan accordingly that, you know, what are the things that I can cut down from my routine of the day.
Right.
I used Scrum framework for my weight loss as well, and I am really proud about the accomplishment that I have made. So what I did is, for every 2 weeks, I used to plan how my work schedule should be, what kind of workout would I include, what kind of diet changes do I want to do. And after every 2 weeks, I would inspect and adapt and see what are the changes, how is my body reacting to the changes that I'm introducing. I learn what is working, what is not working for me, and that's how I did it for almost a year now. And I am pretty fit now. I feel very good about myself. So Scrum has helped me even in my personal life.
Fantastic! Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, so sorry, excited to speak at Regional Scrum Gathering.
Oh, I am actually super excited, I would say. Okay. The first Scrum Gathering that I had attended was in 2016 in Bangalore. And that's where I felt that, you know, there is so much to learn, so much to network, so much to meet and learn from, you know, well-versed practitioners. And from experience is what you learn. Yeah. And the experiences that are being shared in these Scrum Gatherings are so encouraging that I thought I should be always a part of the Scrum Gatherings. And that's the moment I felt, you know, I am being a participant for a long time. Why not become a speaker? And this is the first time I submitted a paper for a speaker proposal, and I got selected. So super excited and looking forward.
Awesome. And I'm sure our viewers would love to hear from you. What would you be speaking on, you know?
Yeah. So this is something that's really, really close to my heart. This is regarding retrospectives. And the topic, to be specific, is smart ways of choosing retrospective techniques. And what I would want to share is practical and proven methods that I have used with my teams, and how did I try to make the retrospectives more effective, more a fun environment, an open environment, so that, you know, team is able and vocal about the issues that they are facing, and how do we come up with improvements, right? So when we Google, there are a lot of retrospective techniques that we see.
Absolutely.
So I have picked up a few of them, and not every team is same, not every sprint is same, not every release is same, because even if the team remains the same, the kind of work that you do might change. The challenges that you face in every sprint and release change. So based on the outcome of the sprints, so scenario-based retrospective is what I would want to share about, very practical scenarios. Awesome. And what kind of technique can we use? This is something that I would want to share.
I'm sure whoever attends the Regional Scrum Gathering would enjoy. And for our general viewers, I want to take a step back and maybe ask, what is a retrospective?
So in very plain terms, retrospective is nothing but inspect what has happened in the past, maybe past 2 or 3 weeks, and then see if there is anything that you would want to continue the same, and is there any improvement that you would want to bring in the next 2 or 3 weeks, so that there is, you become more efficient, right? In very plain, simple terms, say suppose you are planning for a birthday party. Right. You are being a host for a birthday party, you plan as a family on what is the guest list, what could be the menu, what kind of return gifts do you plan. So you plan the entire event, what are the various activities that you would want to do as part of the party. So once the party is done, you meet up again as a family.
Right.
And then you discuss on what things really went well for us, which we should continue in the next party that we would host. What were the things that were not so good, where we could have improved on, right?
Absolutely.
So these are the small little things that we can take care of in the next party that I host, right? So this is nothing but conducting a retrospective.
Okay, fantastic. So, okay, taking the discussion further, let's say the projects or the organizations ignore retrospective, would it be fatal to them? What would be your thoughts?
I think this is an integral part of any project. As I said, we can, you know, we can implement it in our daily life as well. Like one of the examples that I had taken was the hosting a party. So any project or anything that you do in life, if you do not retrospect, if you do not inspect what has happened and what could be improved on, then you are losing an opportunity to improve yourself, to be more efficient, to be more effective in your delivery in the next project. And at the same time, you are actually repeating the same mistakes again and again. So there is no learning out of it, right? Until you actually look back, you would not know what were the mistakes that had happened and how can you improve on. And I think one of the reasons why people lose interest in retrospectives is not seeing a value out of it. And why do we not see a value out of it? Because there is no improvement from the past. And why do we see there is no improvement? Because we tend to forget the improvements that we have discussed. And my paper is all about practical ways. When I say practical ways, how do you ensure the improvements that are discussed during the retrospectives are something that are taken seriously and people remember? And humans remember things only when it is, you know, an activity or a fun game that you introduce during retrospectives, and that's when you remember what you a picture speaks more words than any paragraph that you read.
That's
right. So absolutely. So I think that's what I want to actually tell everybody, that when you do an activity and then from the activity you derive what are the improvements, these are something that the teams would definitely remember on and they'll act upon it.
Sure.
So if we don't do, then definitely it's fatal. You are repeating the same mistakes again and again.
Right. So this involves plenty of team building activities, I guess.
Yes, it does.
Okay. All right. And all right. Satya, so what are the typical challenges that you see with your teams at the with the retrospectives, and how do you address them?
Okay, so I think one of the challenges that I have faced is some of the team members are very shy. They don't open up. At times, teams do not talk about every problem that they face so openly. Maybe there is no trust, or they don't feel so safe about it.
Absolutely.
Or at times, retrospectives are taken as an opportunity for blame game. That also happens.
Yes, right? Absolutely.
So I think all these things happen when there is no healthy work environment, when the teams do not bond with each other so well. At the end of the day, we are all humans.
Absolutely.
Right? And only when the relationships are built strong in a positive way, that's when it will be a very safe environment for anybody to discuss any concern they have. And it will be taken in a positive sense to see exactly what the problem is and how can we solve it.
Absolutely.
Right? But discuss the problem, discuss the issue, but don't discuss the person as such. Right? So what I do is... ensure there are some team building activities that are part of the retrospectives, that are part of any other meetings that we do, so that, you know, that bond is always maintained in a very positive way, and that helps all the teams to actually, you know, keep the retrospectives pretty healthy and effective and come up with good improvement points. But as we have been always discussing about improvements, it doesn't mean that we do not discuss about what really went well, right? So be appreciative on time, talk about the good things that has happened, appreciate the efforts that every individual has put during the sprint. And this is something that keeps the individuals motivated. And I think we should never skip this part in retrospectives.
Fantastic, fantastic. Actually, last 10 to 15 minutes, I learned a lot from you, and I value the retrospectives. And so can we get a sneak preview on the activities that you may do at Regional Scrum Gathering?
I would want that to be a surprise. I'm definitely planning to do one or two activities during the session. Okay. So that the audience get a feel of how do we run it with activities, keep it more engaging with the audience. Okay. Definitely, but I would not want to share it as of now. Let it be a surprise for the event to happen.
Okay, fantastic. Fantastic, Satya. Thanks a lot for your time. And I hope, like me, I'm sure a lot of viewers and the people would be interested in your talk during the Scrum Gathering. So I'm so looking forward to meet you there. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, same here. Thank you so much. Looking forward for the event and looking forward to meet you in person.
Same here.